Now to a very established actress who's having a stellar career, which kick-started when she played Andrea Zuckerman in the early seasons of the iconic 90s television series Beverly Hills 90210.
If you want to tell them.
No, go ahead.
I don't know where to start. Well, come on. Well, first things first. Jesse and I are getting married.
Wow, so we're all going to Vegas.
All right.
So wrong.
Well, good thinking.
All right, man.
Thanks.
Congratulations.
There's just one more thing. We're going to have a baby.
What?
Oh, we're going to have a baby.
You are?
Wow. Oh, I'm so happy.
That's great. I told you this would all work out.
Talk about scandal at the Peach Pit. We're joined now by Gabrielle Carteris from Los Angeles. Hi, welcome. It's great to see you.
Oh, lovely to see you. Thank you. Thank you. Wow, that was a long time ago.
You still look exactly the same, can I just say, Gabrielle? But 30 years ago, can you believe, that show first aired and the legacy still lives on. Must be pretty amazing to be part of such a part of TV history like that.
You know, it's really, it's been 30 years and I'm still overwhelmed by it and surprised and feel very grateful. It was really interesting for me. Oh my God, you're showing other clips. It was so interesting for me to be able to go and do the reboot that we did and have my daughters, who are young adults now, actually start to see the show from when I first had done it to this point. And it was really, it's amazing. I can't believe it's been that many years and it was that life changing, but seeing it through their eyes really reminded me of that. So, and seeing these pictures, of course, do as well.
I'd well imagine, yeah. Beverly Hills 90210 was such a hit. It plays such a huge role in a lot of people's lives. But how did getting the role of Andrea Zuckerman change your life?
It actually defined my whole adult life to be play the role of Andrea Zuckerman. I was, you know, I lived in New York. I was doing theater. I came out to L.A. because I thought, you know, I wanted to be out for what they call pilot season. I auditioned for this show, and who would have ever thought, you know, every job is like the last job you're going to ever get. But it was so iconic that it actually, it shaped the whole trajectory of my adult life. So I've never had an adult life without having 90210 in it. It's pretty profound.
Mm. Whole cast of stars, you were all playing high school students, but you were a little bit older than high school students at the time. Is it true that, what was the fib that you told casting directors about your age?
I lied about my age. I was 29 and I was auditioning for the role of a 16-year-old. And so I looked really young. Look, I'm 200 years old. Look how good I look. So but it was, I lied about my age. And then when I got the job, I actually had to lie on my contract. So I called lawyers to find out, how do I legally sign this contract and still allow them to think I'm very young? And so I was able to do that. And it was, but it was profound. It actually changed, you know, I'm now the president of SAG-AFTRA, which is our actors union. And I think that what I learned at that time and how I had the opportunity to audition being a different age and how technology kind of denies people that ability, I became a fighter and advocate. It was a very interesting place. I started in my career never imagining I'd be here today.
It really is amazing. It's great to hear that you still keep in contact with some of your cast members. I mean, tragically, the world lost your former co-star Luke Perry in 2019 due to a stroke. He was so loved. What was he like to work with in the 90s when he was truly the ultimate teenage heartthrob?
First of all, when he started the show, he was not in our first episode. I don't know if you guys saw that. When he came to be on the show, I remember he came to go for the first read-through, and he said to me, because we had known each other in New York, he said, man, he said, they won't even give me a contract on this. I have to prove myself. I hope I can keep this job for a little while. I really need the money. So he never imagined he'd become the heartthrob. And but he was a lovely, lovely human being. Luke really, he was a humanitarian. He's very generous and he loved the business, but he loved to be an outsider in the business. He was a very interesting person, really kind.
That's a good way to survive it, actually, isn't it?
Sure
just
it
to
is.
Have one foot out. Your daughters, Kelsey and Molly, are now young adults. How much of the original Beverly Hills 90210 have they actually seen? And what do they make of it?
Well, first of all, they never watched it before. I was always shocked. And I was like, you've never seen it? And so when we were going to do the reboot, my oldest daughter, Kelsey, who's going to be 27 in a month, she started to watch it. And she said, Mom, it was a cool show. Like, they had no concept of it, right? Because they were just babies. And Molly, she loves the whole thing about it. But they watched it for the first time just a year and a half, 2 years ago. They thought it was great. And I was like, really? It's lasted that long for you?
So. Isn't it nice, though, when your kids think you're cool?
I know, right? I was like, what do you think I've been doing my whole life? That's like what was... You never understood when people would stop. For them, it was like a nuisance, kind of like, ugh, what's going on, Mom? And now that they've seen it, there's like this whole kind of awareness. It was a very interesting aha moment.
What is it that your girls do? I mean, what's their aspirations?
My oldest daughter is a painter. She's an artist. She lives in New York, and she's very talented. And my other daughter is finishing college right now. She's a singer. She was on American Idol, actually, last year. And she's an artist, but she's still in school. So what she decides to do, I don't know yet. But
very talented family, either way.
Huh?
Very talented family. Yeah, the arts.
You all got together for a reboot not that long ago. What was that like to see all of your old castmates again?
Well, you know, I see each one of them I've seen through the years. You know, Jason and I are still very close. The girls I've seen on and off, and everybody. To be together, it was really emotional. So I was a little giddy. I was a definite, for all of us, kind of a throwback. You know, it was a long time ago, so there was emotional things that we actually needed to talk about. You know, we had been together for, you know, throughout the 10 years the show was on, but we had a lot to talk about, and I think it was really, for me, it was coming full circle. It was wonderful, and it was amazing. Everybody had kids now. Like, we were adults. We were raising our children. Our children were playing together or hanging out while we were shooting. It was amazing. And our kids, they were, you know, for some of them, were the age that we were when we started the show, right? So there was a whole kind of conversation. It was really, really fun. It was, I would never give it up for anything. That was really great to be able to have that time with everybody.
It sounds like you've been so lucky working with a group of people that are almost like family to you. Mm. While we have you, actually, we need to ask you, one of our dear friends, Shana Burgess, she used to be a judge on Dancing with the Stars here in Australia. She has gone public with Brian Austin Green, one of your old cast members. Has she picked a good fella? Is he a nice guy?
He is salt of the earth.
Oh.
She is a very, very lucky woman. He is all about family and love, and he's sweet and kind, and yes, I say winner, winner, winner.
Oh, I love it. Okay, well, if they get married, we should be put on the same table together and have some fun. I think that's a good idea.
I think so. I think we would have a very good time.
I think we'd have a great time. I had pictures of you on my wall growing up, Gabrielle. Thank you so much for talking to us. You are divine.
Oh, you are divine. Thank you so much.